Hey, welcome. My name is Chinde Chinde, and I'm the founder of Married Life Management and the author of the book, What Can I Do to Make My Marriage Work? In today's video, I'll be talking about stop focusing only on erotas in your marriage. What is erotas? Where is that word from? Sounds very bizarre and ugly. Anyway, erotas is a Greek word, and it means intimate or sexual love. Now, you've heard most times they say, love will not make your marriage work. So what they are referring to is erotas. And another word that is very close to erotas is eros. We're talking about erotic love, sexual love, intimate kind of love. Now, if you wonder, where did this come about? Where Eros was a god of love in the ancient Greek mythology. We're told that he's got magical power, that when he fires his bows, he can make people fall in love. And he's a son to the goddess of love, Aphrodite. But anyway, that's not what I'm going to focus on here. I'm just focused on that meaning, Eros. This is another kind of love expression. In the Western culture today, they call that the romantic love, whereby you engage yourselves, you get involved in sexual pleasure, you get involved in sexual activities. This kind of love exists in the movies, you see them in social medias, in Instagrams, in celebrities and all that. But I just want you to know that focusing only on sexual love, focusing only on romantic love, would that actually make your marriage work? Well, you can see it's all over the place that it's not actually the best kind of love to make marriage survive, work and become thriving and interesting. And this erotic love is also found in the scriptures. If you look at the Songs of Solomon, we're told that Solomon was very erotic to his wife. And that book, the Songs of Solomon, is full of a lot of erotic, pleasure-giving kind of love. When you focus only on erotic love, then you might hit some serious rock, because you're not going to be always feeling super horny. You're not going to be feeling all the time infatuated, pleasure giving and all that. And that is why when you hear that love only is not enough to make marriage work, they are talking about Eros kind of love. But there's an alternative. Now, where is it coming from? What is the source of this alternative? Let's look at 1 John chapter 4 verse 8. The Bible says God is love. So I'm talking about the agape kind of love. What's this kind of love? What does he do? This is the love that is called selfless love, self-sacrificing love, self-giving love. It's very unconditional. The key thing around this kind of love is it does not seek for gain. It doesn't look for applause or recognition. Think about this. I mean, we have in our Western world today, there's a lot of charity organizations. They go to where there is war. They go to help the women that have been trafficked. They go to go help the homeless. They support all kinds of different events and ventures in order to bring people happiness and joy. Think about them giving their time, their money, their intellect, their expertise without anything in return. That's exactly what I'm talking about. That's exactly what I'm sharing here. But what's the origin? We're all human, made by God. God have shared some level of this agape kind of love towards us so that we'll be able to help and support people that are seriously in need. Think about in your marriage. Think about in your relationship. If you become selfless, if you become self-giving, very unconditional, if you're always looking for the well-being of your spouse, your marriage will thrive. Your marriage will succeed. You'll be better and better every day. Now, if you want to know more about the action of this kind of agape kind of love, in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it talks about love is patient. It talks about love is kind. It talks about love forgiving. It talks about love is not proud. Love does not rejoice when something is happening to their spouse. This kind of love never fails. It's full of actions. The question you need to ask, you, selfish, do you have this kind of love? And if you don't, why don't you go to the source? God is love, and he's the source of agape kind of love. A love that is very unconditional, that is free, but if only you will come to accept it. That's why he gave his son Christ to die for us, in order for us to have this love in our heart. In your marriage and your relationship, keep asking yourself, what kind of love are you displaying? Are you just displaying the erotic kind of love? When you don't have that erotic kind of love, what happened? Some people say, well, it's over. They give up. But that's not how God treats you and I. God wants us to have the agape kind of love in our marriage, in our relationship, in order to make our relationship thrive, better, and successful. Now, before I go, I just want to say that the love framework is going to have so much to talk about, all kind of love, what we need to do, and also to empower you to love sacrificially as someone that is willing to give all without asking for anything in return. When the husband, when the wife have this kind of mindset, their marriage will thrive and it will work. If you like this video, share and comment so that we can reach more people. And I can't wait to unveil the Love Framework Master Program that can support and empower many marriages around the world. God bless you. Have a nice day.